Welcome back to the Chasm channel. In today's tutorial, we'll take a look at the PDF viewer in WinCCOA. Hey Sean, so today we're going to take a look at the PDF viewer in WinCCOA. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Of course, the PDF viewer inside of WinCCOA is a widget that allows you to reference documents that are in PDF format.
Okay, thank you. Sounds pretty useful. Let's go check it out.
Okay, so let's get started. The first thing that I'm going to do is launch I'm going to launch the console. And if you are new to these tutorials, most of them we use the delivered getting started tutorial project that comes delivered with the software. And I'm using WinCCOA version 3.16 patch 11 for this. So this is the console. I'm selecting the getting started project and I'm going to start this. While that's getting started, I am going to create a folder that I'm going to look at and reference a PDF folder. So I'm going to create a new folder and call it PDF. Okay, and this is going to come into play here in a second. Let's take a look at the project that we're going to be working with. Okay, I'm just going to launch a user interface right here. Quickly log in, and we're going to look at this process overview. So the getting started tutorial is a rudimentary, hey, this is how you can work with the software type project so you can get used to like building objects and understanding the workflow of development. So for this demo, I am going to pull up information on this page in a PDF format. I'm going to pull up information for this panel in a PDF format to understand how this panel works. And how this could be applicable in the real world is if an operator was looking at this as a, you know, their operations screen and maybe they're new and they want to understand how the different clicks and buttons of this navigation work, well then we'll use a PDF. So I'm going to close this and we'll just start building it. All right. So I'm going to open up the help file and I am going to find a PDF for that. So if you type in getting started, it will give me a link here, and if I click that and then sync with the table of contents, it will actually show me where at in this navigation contents tree that search item was. Okay, so I'm going to find the actual project. So give me a second. This might be it. Nope, that is not it. Okay, so this is the one. This is showing the graphic. It's showing all the different components, the behaviors of the clicks, the pop-up panels, and so on. So I'm going to create a PDF for this. And we are going to create a PDF. And I'm going to save it in the PDF folder that I just created. And we are going to call it Process Overview. Save it. I'm going to go check if it's there to make sure. And yes, so we have the PDF created and saved. Next, I want to do a search for WinCC EWO. EWO stands for Extended Widget Object, and it talks about all the different widgets that are available inside of WinCC Open Architecture. So if we look at the toolbar here in the graphical editor, the Getty, you can see the PDF viewer, the web viewer, maps, gauges, a bunch of the different widgets that are available inside of WinCCOA. So if I go back here, I'm looking at the PDF E extended widget object. I'm going to click that. It gives me an example in the help files. And what I'm looking for is this simple script right here that talks about loading the PDF for the particular widget and then where it is pulling the PDF from. Okay. So in my panels, I'm going to open the process here and I want to build just another window or screen or panel that has the reference, which is the PDF. And this is, each panel can be considered an object that has properties and methods. So this is my new panel that I'm going to create, and I'm going to make it 600 wide and 800 tall. And then I'm going to add the PDF widget to it. Okay. And then with this widget, I'm going to create an initialize script because I would like it to, as soon as that window opens, to run that script and call the run the script that I just created. So I know that the PDF I just saved is in my C drive in this PDF folder, and it's called process overview. So if I go here, keep in mind the script editor, the control script editor in WinCC OA is case sensitive. So keep that in mind when working with it. Process overview, and don't forget the file extension, which is .pdf. We'll do a syntax check on it, say okay, and then we're gonna put this in quick test mode. It's gonna ask me to save the file. So I'm gonna put it in my examples folder, which is located right here. And we will quick test this to see if it works. And it does not work. So I probably messed up something on my, well, let's make sure I know what this object is called. PDFEWO, okay. PDFEWO1, okay. That looks good. And I'm going to comment this out, and I'm going to check something to make sure that it's going to run properly. I'm adding the example that they have in the help files before I look at the one that I want to actually look at. Okay. And then we'll compare the script, see if I missed anything. One more time. Okay, so it works. It is looking at the folder that I just created, the PDF folder, and running this. Okay, so now we want to call this screen inside of this. Next thing I want to do is just create a button, and this can be, you know, look and feel however you want it to feel. Like, it could be a text link that says about this page. It could be a button. It could be, you know, an image that has a help, you know, icon or something like that. But I'm just going to call this button about learn about this panel. Okay. And now I want to create a click script for it. I want to create a set panel function. I want to open a panel in a new module. And I'm going to go select the panel I just created. So in the examples folder, now I go to the PDF example, hit OK, and then it's going to give me options. Do I want a child panel, which is going to pop up in the same window, or a root panel that's basically its own panel, which will navigate me away from the screen itself. So I'm just going to do it as a child panel pop-up, center it, And then I always want it on top because I'm probably going to be reading it or referencing it while I'm right there on the plant floor or wherever I am accessing the HMI screen. Okay, so we'll hit finish. Going to test this really quick. And there is the PDF pop-up. All right, so let's close this. And we've created the pop-up, we've created the PDF. Now let's go look at it in the actual runtime. So I'm going to start my user interface, log in, and I'm going to choose a different template to look at this. The template I'm going to choose is this responsive one for my monitor that I'm working on right now. So I hit OK, log in, expand my screen, go to my process overview, and learn about this panel. Click that, and I can go fit and view. And there is my PDF for references about this screen or panel that is built with a few different options for the user to use with the built-in PDF viewer. So that's it for this tutorial. I'll kick it back over to you, James.
All right, Sean, thanks for doing that. That was a useful tutorial. We did notice that there seemed to be a little bit of an issue at first getting the PDF viewer going. What happened there?
Well, just make sure and pay attention to the control editor, the script editor. It is case sensitive, and I misspelled PDF.
Oh, okay. Well, thank you, Sean, and thank you for watching. Remember to subscribe to the Chasm channel and click that bell to stay notified of future updates.